25 years of Delphi. Can you imagine? We are 2020 and in 95 everything started with the release of Delphi 1. To celebrate this, we organized a mini museum, a mini Delphi museum here in our offices. I give you today a guided tour in this museum and we start with the table of CDs. I know, these days the CDs are long past, long gone by, but back in the days the CD was the medium to transfer software. It all started with, before Delphi, Borland Pascal 7.0, and after this release we saw the first version of Delphi 1 in 95, and this was the original Delphi 1 CD that was used to deliver the software. CDs were in these days also used for beta versions. The downloads of a beta, of a full version of Delphi, would be way too large and at that time, and therefore Borland sent us, as a technology partner of Borland, sent us the beta on CDs. Iliad was such a beta version, and as you can see, there have been in total 4 different betas of Iliad. So every time the team made progress, we received by regular mail a new CD with the beta, and of course we were excited opening the mailbox that there was a new beta, immediately installed it and started exploring what was new in the next version of Delphi that would be come out. CDs were also used for conference material. The Borland conference, Borcom, they distributed all the white papers, presentations, samples, demo code, etc. on a CD. So let's come and move to this table. And here we are at the table of t-shirts. Software developers love t-shirts, and so we have here this collection of t-shirts related to Delphi, beginning with the Borcon t-shirts. Every year in the US we had the Borcon conference, and every year there was a new t-shirt, a different t-shirt with a different design, together with the badge and the materials, the papers, the books, etc. We got this bag, so all the attendees, over 1,000 attendees in these days, the beginning of 2000, were running around at the conference with a bag like this. Borcon was by far not the only conference. And for example, till this day, the Econ conference in Germany is still running. Also this year, in October, you can go to the Econ conference, and every year the Econ conference offers a different t-shirt. We also have the Delphi Days in Italy, the SDN conference in the Netherlands, and another one where you will for sure find a lot of Delphi heads in Germany is the Delphi Tage, typically running in September of the year. Here is also a special t-shirt I wanted to talk about, which is the black Borland t-shirts. You can see it's also here in gray, beige and red, but the black one was special. The black one was normally only for Borland employees. So if you were at a conference and someone was wearing the black t-shirts, you were sure that this was a Borland employee. Of course, you will understand that this was really something I wanted, and never being a Borland employee, I somehow managed to get the real black one, Borland t-shirts. More t-shirts, of course, this one here, being an MVP, I'm proud to have received this Embarcadero MVP t-shirts. Other gadgets, and also t-shirts in connection with new features that became available in Delphi, the FireMonkey t-shirts. When Android was added as a platform in Delphi, there was an Android t-shirt. And this one was also a very cool t-shirt. My app is faster than yours. Of course, being a Delphi developer, it's clear that you are proud to wear this t-shirt and highlighting how fast our Delphi apps are in comparison with other technologies. Let's move now to the books table. And we start with where it all started, Component Writer's Guide for Delphi 1. Back in the days, Delphi was shipped in a big box, not only with a CD, but also with a bunch of books. And this was the first book about component writing, packed with Delphi 1. It's quite clear that we learned a lot and a lot of exciting things from these books. Here we have Delphi 2, 4, 5, and then was the time for Linux. Delphi was for the first time going cross-platform, going to Linux, and the Linux version of Delphi in these days was called Kylix. So there was Kylix, and there was of course also Kylix books, this one. And then two special books, Secrets of Delphi 2 and The Hidden Paths to Delphi 3. Both written by Ray Lischner and both excellent books. Both books that learned me a lot and a lot of things about the internal workings of the components, the component framework, RTTY, but also in particular a lot of things in connection to the IDE, extending the IDE, the APIs that the IDE exposes to write property editors, to change behavior in the object inspector, etc., etc. Even till today, these books are still relevant. So if you can still get a copy of these books, if you don't have it already, rush to Amazon or similar websites and get your second-hand copy of these fantastic books. And this brings us to a table with newer books. And the first one, or the series that I wanted to highlight, is these books, the books of the Delphi Developer Days. Delphi Developer Days are organized by Carrie Jensen and with a partner, in this case it was Bob Swart. It was organized in several cities over the world, also in Germany. I attended, for example, several Delphi Developer Days. It was like a 3-2-day workshop, and you got a book that thick when you attended the workshop. So a lot of knowledge was transferred every time, over and over again, during the Delphi Developer Days. Here we have a book, Delphi Expert, written by Pavel Glowacki. Pavel, who sadly passed away. It was extremely disturbing to learn that Pavel passed away, because I personally met Pavel numerous times at conferences. Pavel was working out of Amsterdam for Borland first, then Embarcadero. And this was the book that Pavel wrote. Another really famous Delphi developer is Primoz, of course. And Primoz wrote the OmniThread framework, and wrote also these two fantastic books, books that you cannot miss if you want to get the most out of Delphi. And we have more brilliant people. Nick Hodges. Nick Hodges, who has been working for Embarcadero. And Nick also wrote two not to miss books on Delphi. And then of course we have Carrie Jensen. If you thought that the client dataset just could keep some data in a buffer, make no mistakes, a client dataset offers lots and lots of functionality. And so Carrie Jensen devoted this book to client datasets. And of course we cannot forget maybe the most famous book writers of all, Marco Cantu, who also wrote various books on different versions of Delphi, each time covering the latest advancements in the language, features of the IDE, etc. And it goes without saying that I am also particularly proud of this book, written by John Koraklis. And John wrote a book on our Delphi ORM named Aurelius. So if you want to learn everything about Aurelius, I can only recommend it. Excellent book. And now this brings us to the table of magazines. We all grew up with magazines where we learned every month new stuff about software and more in particular about Delphi. There was, for example, this edition of Pinnacle about Delphi from the US. Also in the US was the Delphi Informant magazine. And as you can see, every month there was a new magazine, so there was always something new to learn. Exciting times. Delphi Informant from the US and their brothers, so to speak, from Europe, the Delphi magazine that was being brought from the UK, also on a monthly basis. Germany is also here, of course, is also represented, and a lot of information about Delphi programming was to be found every month in the Toolbox magazine, a German magazine. Another German magazine that still exists these days is Entwickler, still available every month, and even up till these days, they cover Delphi stuff from time to time. So check it out in your bookstore every month, the Entwickler magazine. This one I couldn't forget to put here on the table. The Dr. Dobbs Journal, famous software development magazine with, of course, the man who started it all, Anders Helsberg, the inventor of Delphi, the man who created it in 1995, and up till today, what he created, the framework he created, is still so good, solid, beautiful written. So all honor to Anders Helsberg. That's why I keep this Dr. Jobs journal. And this brings us back to the UK, the PC Plus. PC Plus was a general computer magazine. And what was special about PC Plus was that every month they added a CD on this magazine, a CD packed with all kinds of software. And at regular intervals, they included a kind of, let's say, community edition in these days of Delphi. So lots of people could discover what Delphi was offering to them, the power that Delphi brought to them, by picking up the magazine in the bookstand and then get started with Delphi that was included on that CD. Here we have it for, this was a version of Delphi 1, and here, somewhat later, there was a Delphi 4 covered on this magazine. And with that connection, we go to that CD. The CD that came with PC Plus was called initially the Super CD, then it became a DVD, obviously, as software grew larger and larger and larger. And so here you have an example of Delphi that was included on this Super CD. Another edition of Delphi here is Delphi 1. And so we had it for Delphi 3, 2. So plenty of opportunity for magazine readers to discover versions of Delphi. Even Kylix here was included at some point when they moved to DVDs. And the Delphi Informant magazine that was on the magazine table also published the contents of their magazine, all packed on one CD. So very convenient if you wanted to search back in all the information that was written on a monthly basis. This one has been in our office for years and years, and these, in my opinion, are three cool stickers made in Borla. Delphi developers do it faster. I believe we still do until today. And go.com yourself, that was the sticker that was launched when the internet was literally exploding in the middle of the 90s. Several other Borland gadgets I have here, like this towel, the Borland towel, the Borland calculator, you could definitely count on it, or a Borland badge, a coffee mug to keep you awake during the nights of programming, cannot be forgotten. And Borland also tried to create a version of Delphi for the .NET framework. And in that era, there was, of course, also some gadgets related to Delphi, related to .NET. And this brings us to this final small table, TMS. We have been developing components ever since Delphi started, from 1995. 25 years of excitement, 25 years of fun, of exploring, of creativity, discovering new features all the time. So it has been really a 25 years fun and a joyful experience. And over the years, you can see our original logo here. Over the years, we also collected a number of awards. This one was actually the very first one in 2002 from the Delphi Informant magazine that you have seen. And not to forget also more recently, awards from the Blaise Pascal magazine for our FNC framework and the WebCore framework. 25 years of fun, excitement, fantastic experiences. Lots of nice people in the Delphi community that we met all over the world. I can only wish that this adventure can go on for the next 25 years.